into enzo into apa ekseni nje ezweni lenkosi.
I'm trying to combine two things or two messages together.
Ngokuhlanganisa imiyalezo emibili ngihlanganise umyalezo omnye.
And I will do that in the next 45 minutes together.
Ngizoyenza lo nto kule mizuzu i 45 izayo.
I want to say to the ministers.
Ngifuna ukuthi ke kubafundisi.
We've heard, we've been sitting here, we've been learning this weekend.
Sivile besithophe kule ndawo simamele yonke le mperafiki.
Now you've got to pass the test.
Ngoku ke kufuneke nipasile ke uvavanye.
Go and implement.
Hambani ke niyowenza.
Go and do what you've learned.
Hambani yowenza lento niyifundileyo.
But we are not as good when it comes to implementation.
Asikho bahle kakhulu ke xa kufikelela kwelicandelo lokwenza.
It's not only you here.
Hayi uba nini nodwa apha.
But we go to the apostles, the disciples, we see the same trend.
Xa sibuyela kwapostolo nabadisayipile kukakristu sibona kwa into enye.
We are good at sitting down and learning.
Sibahle kwecala lokuhlala phansi.
And we can even say, yes, what a weekend, what a weekend.
Sithi, ah, asiyamnandi mpelaveki ethini.
But when it comes to implementation,
kodwa xa kuzakwe icandelo lokwenza,
we are very sloppy and slack when it comes to that.
See, asikwazi tu ukwenza into esifundileyo.
So I say this morning, go and implement, pass the test.
Namhlanje ke apha ekusendini masihambe siyokwenza, silubhansi uphumelele uvavanye.
My message is pass the test.
Imthumele yami ithi uphumelele uvavanye.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We combine two messages. Let's go to the book of Matthew chapter 15.
See every two at Matthew, we start to say Shimon and Shimon.
Joseph. We know that he was God, 100% God, but he's still 100% man.
Sas uthi wayenguThixo qebelele ekwangumntu qebelele.
He learned some things from Joseph about treating women.
Wafunda into kuYosefu indlela yokuphatha abantu besifazane.
Because Joseph said when he discovered that his wife to be was pregnant.
Mhla uYosefu wafumana ukuthi intombi azoyichata ikhulelwe.
He didn't want to throw her away in shame.
Akazange afuneke ukumhlambalaza bamlahle emhlazweni.
If it was me and you, especially man, madoda.
Ubaba kusithi thina madoda.
And then suddenly Ntombi yakho is pregnant.
Ntombi le ucinga uzayitshata evele ikhulelwe.
You're going to make sure that you prove that you are innocent and she's guilty.
Uzawenza indlela zokuziveza uba wena umsulwa yena unetyala.
But not Joseph.
Kodwa hayi uYosefu.
So Jesus learned something from Joseph.
UYesu ke wafunda izinto ezithile kuYosefu.
And he didn't want to treat women in shame.
Engafuni ukuphatha abantu basetyhini ngokakubi.
One day they brought a woman to Jesus and said, "We caught her right at the verge of adultery."
Basa ngemibini owesifazane kuye besithi simbambile esenza ukrecheso.
Jesus said, "If there's anyone amongst you who does not have sin," he was writing with his foot, "anyone who doesn't have sin, take the first stone and cast it upon him."
UYesu ebhala phansi ngonyawo lakhe wathi kukhona kuno ngenasono ngathathi litye amnete.
And they all left.
Bonke ke bahamba.
Turn to the woman.
Wajika wathongo wasechini.
Said, "I'm not throwing you away. I'm not sending you away.
Wathi ngoti,
but sin no more.
Ungabuye uphinde hone."
We see this trend on how we treat women.
Siyibona ngale ndlela yokuphatha abantu basifazane.
But on this particular day,
kodwa ke ngaleni mina ekhethekileyo,
the woman comes running.
Kukhona wasechini wezibaleka.
Jesus says nothing.
UYesu akakhupha nelimdaka.
The woman is shouting.
Uyakhwaza wesifazane.
Lord have mercy, son of David.
Nyana ka David manenceba kaku.
And Jesus says nothing.
UYesu akakhupha ditshone nelimdaka.
Quiet.
Wathi tu.
Why?
Uthi.
How come?
Kanjani?
What has changed?
Ushintshe lo.
Why, Lord, do you keep quiet?
Utheni Yesu wathula?
And the woman is running and crying.
Owesifazane abale kuyeza uyakhala.
The answer is simple.
Impendulo nje lula.
He was saying to his disciples,
"Why sit you bafundi bakhe?
You have seen me.
Nindibonile.
I've done it.
Yenze.
Do it.
Yenzeni na.
Help this woman.
Tsedana owesifazane.
How many of you are teachers?
Banga papa kuna banga bantu bafundisayo
a teacher. When it's examination time,
xa ilixesha lovavanyo,
he keeps quiet.
Ithuliti twake.
Even if the teacher is in the house,
ndijonga ukuthi teacher xa usendlini.
When it's examination time,
xa ilixesha lovavanyo,
he can't help you.
Akakwazi ukunceda.
He keeps quiet.
Uthi tu.
Now the greatest teacher, Jesus.
Umfundisi omkhulu uYesu.
He says to his disciples.
Uthi kubafundi bakhe.
You have seen me.
Nibonile.
I've been dealing with people.
Kudala ngisebenza nabantu.
I've been healing people.
Kudala ngiphilisa abantu.
I've just fed 5,000.
Ndidalo Jesuswe.
I just walked on water.
Ndihambe phezu kwamanzi.
You have seen me.
Nibonile.
Here comes a woman.
Uzowesifazane.
Help her.
Ncedeni.
Deal with it.
Sebenzani.
You've been here the whole weekend.
Benilapha ngempela vele yonke.
It's a test that is waiting for you.
Ukho kuvavanya umlinge mina.
Wena phaya uthi
play. Hamba ukusebenza lento enifunde
mina. Go and help people out there.
Abanye nceda abantu ngaphandle.
What?
Kodwa
they failed that test.
Bohlulakala ke lolo vavanyo.
They failed.
Bohlulakala.
Listen. Do what they do.
Mamela ukuthi bathi.
They go to Jesus.
Baya kuYesu.
And say, "Jesus,
but Yesu."
They didn't say in a polite way.
Abazange batho ngendlela ke.
Send her away.
But Yesu, God.
Nkosi.
Send her away.
They are not saying,
incinete.
Number one, they fail to help her.
Okokuqala bohlule kumncede.
And secondly, they say, send her away.
Okwesibini bathi Yesu God.
They failed the test.
Mahluleka ke luvava.
They failed.
Bohluleka luvava.
May God help us not to fail the test.
Angasifethu ba usohluleki luvava.
People come crying to us.
Uma bantu besiza ukuthi bekhala.
Give them something.
Sibanikeze into.
Give them what you have.
Sibanike into esinayo.
Say in the name of Jesus.
Sigameni lika Yesu. Wasenza.
Rise up and
vuka kuwa.
Don't fail the test.
Ungahluleki luvava. Cholo fafa.
And then Jesus says,
"Atu Jesus."
You know this verse has been a complicated verse for me. Complicated.
Ela ni verse ayangiyabanzima apa kum.
Because Jesus said,
"Oba uyesu uthi,
I am not sent to the sheep. I'm only sent to the sheep of the lost house. I mean, the sheep of lost sheep of the house of Israel."
Ndithunyelwe ke kwizimvu zaba Israel.
Now analyze this.
Kwelela kana.
Jesus is not talking to the woman.
Uyesu akathenti nalowo wasechini.
Check the scripture.
Talk the Bible.
He's not talking to the woman.
Akathenti nowo wasechini.
He's talking to his disciples.
Uthenta abafundi bakhe.
He's saying to his disciples.
Uthi kubafundi bakhe.
You think I'm only sent to the house of Israel?
Uthi nicinga bani thunyelwe kwindlu kaIsrayeli yodwa.
That's why you think I should not help this woman.
Ingakho nicimba manje ngamncedi lo wasejini.
And you call her dog.
And you need yinja.
Because the Israelites used to call the Canaanite dogs.
Ngoba abaSirembe bebiza amaKanana njengezinja inhlala.
I thank God for this woman.
Dabula loThixo ngalo wasejini.
Because she realized that he's not talking to me.
Waqonda ukuthi akathethi nami.
He's talking to his disciples.
Uthetha nabafundi bakhe.
When she heard that, she went down and
worshiped.
I don't know how she was worshiping.
And that's why you do this again, child.
But she worshiped.
God, what do this?
And the disciples still missed it.
But abafundi bakhe bayisola.
The woman is worshiping.
Always was her, now you do this.
And they're not joining in the worship.
Oh, now I'm getting up about Tunis. But me.
Pass the test. Jesus says,
"What means?"
The woman says, "Yeah, Lord, hey, that's great." After Jesus said, "It's not fit to take the bread, children's bread, and cast it to dogs."
The woman says,
"What means?" I know dogs. I think
that's us,
Dogs are satisfied with the little that they get.
Siyonela nje umfukwanyana wento encinci
esifumana. They don't need the whole meat.
Abayidingi yonke imkutsha.
Just a small thing they will be satisfied.
Kodwa izinja nje zibulela le cake encintshwela nje.
They eat from the crumbs that fall from the table.
Zitsheke kumkhuku netshiyekele white afili.
Sis was saying, so I don't need the whole lot. I just need something to heal my daughter.
Ama picha nje ayidingi yonke kodwa ufuna nje into ezophilisa intombi yami egula.
Jesus says,
"What Yesu?
I have never seen such faith.
But ngidala nilapha emhlabeni andizange ndalibona olunje ukhona.
Akwenzeke kuwe njengokholwa kwakho.
Let it be as you wish."
That girl was healed. That daughter was healed.
Yaphila ke intombazana yalo mama.
Because of a persistent woman of faith.
Ngenxa yomama owabambelela ekhona.
But the disciples failed.
Kodwa abafundi bakhe balitshova.
I believe when Jesus sat down with them somewhere alone.
Nakhona ukuthi uYesu xa ehleli nabo endaweni nje nobodwa.
He said to them, "Boys, you failed."
Wathi bafana, "Angitshonile."
You let me down.
Impossible.
You had an opportunity to help a woman and you turned her over to me. And you said I must chase her away.
Beninethuba lomncedi wesifazana kodwa nize kungathi bathi mgxothe.
Ministers.
Bafundisi.
Let's not fail the test.
Asina tshono vavanyo.
There's a test for us.
Kukhona uvavanyo. Usibekelele.
One of those tests.
Enye yalo vavanyo.
That we have to pass.
It's
found in the book of 2 Kings.
Chapter 13.
Reading from verse 20. And Elisha died. And they buried him. And the bands of the Moabites invaded the land at the coming in of the year. Then it came to pass as they were burying a man, that behold, they spied a band of men, and they cast the man into the sepulcher of Elisha. And when the man lay down, he touched the bones of Elisha. He revived and stood up on his feet. Pass the test. Here's another test. The test of passing on the mantle. The test of passing on to the next generation. The test of empowering the next generation of leaders. There's no success without succession. The truth of the matter is, one day me and you are going to leave this world. Who's going to take over from us? In your local church, who's going to take over from you? What are you doing to empower the next generation? What are you doing when you see a young man coming up in your local church? To encourage him, or do you suppress him? To encourage that young girl that seems to be coming up. We can't be here forever. We won't be here forever. So let's allow those boys and girls that are coming. Let's encourage them. Let them walk by our side.
Passing
by here. The legacy. will be when this people that will take over and carry on when we are gone.
Kungaba bantu abelizovela baba bantu bazothatha thina xa siyambile.
Pass the test.
Phumelela uvavanyo.
Look at this.
Jonga lento.
Here is Elisha.
Apha kuElisha.
He died.
Ufile.
He is buried.
Ungcwatshiwe.
His bones,
amathambo akhe,
in the grave,
as a tomb,
are full of fire,
agcwele umlilo,
are full of anointing,
agcwele intambiso,
such that one day,
kuthi ngenye imini,
they were burying somebody,
babengcwaba nje umuntu.
We don't even know if he was a Christian.
Asazi noma wayekholwa noma wayengakholwa.
We don't know whether umhede noma umhamede. We don't know, but we somebody. As they were burying him, nicely, they raised their eyes, they see a band of invaders coming to them. And they decide, oh, we can't be nice about this funeral anymore.
Babona izigebenga sizisikhele umbathi asikwazi-ke ngokuyenza ngesithozela.
Let's throw this thing in and bury it and go.
Bathi masigcwabe sisidumbu sisigcwabe sihambe.
Some people are like
abanye abantu banenhla
right at the edge of it
xa segqibeleni nasekupheleni kwa
through the man inside
ayigandele indoda ngaphakathi
somehow
njenganje sangendlela ethile
his dead body
umzima lowakufileyo
came into contact with the bones of Elisha.
Wagcinana namathambo kaElisha.
Just the bones.
Amathambo omileyo. Ayikho iBhayibhile wavuka.
No! It says he stood up.
Ithi iBhayibhile asukuma. Elisha,
what is so much anointing doing in the grave?
If una toni tambi swenga ane matuni,
why take the anointing to the grave?
We sabi tambi.
We're supposed to use the anointing.
We're supposed to use 7 feet in the tambi so.
And pass it on.
We should use the anointing.
Don't go with it to the grave.
So you're falling.
Look at somebody.
Chong.
And pour it on.
We can never go forward.
Yeah. Go forward.
Go forward.
Chapter 2 says,
it's as close as you fit.
And it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah.
When to heaven. When I courses or church really and church is
by will
is on touch and then coyers number
that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal or Bakaruham.
O Elia wa no Elisha ba pege Gilgali that
and Elijah says unto Elisha.
What you will Elia or Elisha?
I want you to make a choice.
The phone I get okay.
I want you to choose.
The full kid.
Whether you want to come with me.
Or
you want to stay.
Or the full share.
You can stay here. Because God has sent me to Bethel.
What's the
test?
And
Elisha says,
what do you want to do, Elisha?
As the Lord liveth. And as I shall live it,
as I'm disappear,
I will not leave you.
So the look she.
I'm going with you.
Yeah,
let's go over to
Bethel.
I know the Lord did not send me to Bethel.
Yes,
but he sent you to Bethel.
What to Mena when in Bethel?
And I'm going with you.
What are the Yama now?
As you go to Bethel,
I will
be on your side. I won't overtake you.
And this will rule.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Okay, come on.
zanonke.
And Elisha says,
I'm not staying here. I want to cross the rivers with you.
So
I want to see how you cross a river.
So
this young man passed the test here. He ticks all the boxes. He ticks all the boxes. And it came when they come to the river. Elijah took the mantle. He ruled it. And strike the water.
A better man.
The water separated.
A greater man.
Him, oh Jesus, help us, Lord. Help us, Jesus, help us, Lord. Him and Elisha.
Yeah, no,
they walked on dry land. Water was standing beside, and water was standing beside, and they walked.
Elisha.
Hey, this young man.
Yes.
If he stayed in Bethel, he would have missed this experience.
Separated,
afraid, they walked. They walked together on dry ground.
It came to pass, verse 9, when they were gone over, that Elijah said unto Elisha, now, you've been with me to Bethel. You've been with me to Jericho. You've been with me across the river. Now ask.
Who's that?
Can you imagine? If he stayed in Bethel,
he
would have missed an opportunity to ask. Don't give up at Bethel. Don't give up at Jericho. Don't give up by the waters. An opportunity is about to open before you. Don't give up, young man. An opportunity is just about to open before you. Don't rush to open the ministry. Something is about to open before you.
We are
not about opening ministries and churches here. Jesus died for the church.
Yes, one thing.
I never died for the church. I cannot open my church. This is upon this rock I will build my church. He says, listen, young man, ask for what I shall do for you before I go.
Elisha says, I'm not going to ask for a car.
And so tell him what?
Because the anointing will bring the car. I'm not going to ask for a house.
And so tell him what?
Because the anointing will bring the house. I'm not going to ask for that. Everything I have, when I have the anointing brings everything into the house. So he said,
Adi,
let me ask you. Said I must ask.
So
now I'm asking. I ask for double portion. I ask for a double portion of the anointing. I want it twice only. Not just once now. Because I've seen you in Bethel. Because I've seen you in Jericho. Because I've seen you in the river. I'm going back to that same river. I'm going back to Jericho. I need double portion as I go back.
hard thing. Elijah says, hey,
but really,
I never told you to ask for this. This is a hard thing.
It's in my letter.
You can't ask from me something that I don't have. I have one portion.
The name of the Lord, it comes from you.
That I got from the Lord.
And if you better say that.
Now, if you want double, where am I going to get it from?
So it gets fun up.
You can't report it to
the
this man asked for a
hard thing.
This is a young man that you're standing here. I want you to ask for a hard thing. And young ladies, I want you to ask for a hard thing from the Lord. You know where you're going. Don't ask for a cow with a wheel in the bed, man. And then Elijah says,
okay,
I cannot give you a double portion. But what was it? You follow me.
Where are they?
Walk with me.
Because when I'm taken, I said you have me, the heavens must open. I am coming through a chariot.
So happen.
So the chariot will have to open the skies.
In my
Mula.
It's Baraka.
As the sky is open, it flames Baraka.
Something will come from there. It comes from there. This anointing, you cannot get it from me. It comes from above. As I am taken up, you will see the Lord, the heavens open, and you will receive an anointing. Then it happened. As Elijah was taken up, he threw the mantle. He threw it unto Elisha.
Elisha got it from Elijah.
Who took over from Elisha? Who's the next prophet after Elisha? Who passed it on? Did Elisha pass it on to anyone?
Elisha
held it on. Till he died. Went to the graves. With the anointing. The anointing is still there. Baba, Mfundisi, don't die with this thing. So, no father, let your peace. I want you symbolically this morning. If not, we go, never say anything. I want you to come here. He said that. You know that. Choose any of these young people. Everybody, I've been holding my family, I've been in the backyard. Choose one. Symbolically, we are saying, this is a booty up. I'm not going to die with this thing. And this whole far, and then passing it on to you.
Yes,
please. Instead of boy, don't die with it. Pass it on to somebody else. Pass this gospel to somebody else. Pass this message of the cross to somebody else. Pass this cross to somebody else. Pass this gospel to somebody else. The world is confused, but pass this thing on. It's something that we got from the Lord. Spirit. Keep them in the portion of the anointing. Keep them in the portion of the anointing. Father, give them faith, instant keeper. That they have the portion of the anointing. Give them, Lord. 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 Receive it, receive it, receive it. Receive it is coming now. Receive it is coming. Receive it is coming to you. Receive it is coming to you. Receive it is coming. Receive it is coming.
Marketplace.
This is a group.
May God bless you at home.
A car.
May God bless your children. May God bless everything that you touch. May
it
cause you to prosper. May
it
bless everything that comes out of your hands. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Bless the Lord. God bless you, church. God willing,
to
be back here in April.
We
celebrate together
in
a convention. God bless you.